Yeah.
Albert got all this,
right? Join the job too much, he doesn't need any money.
Yeah, that's fine.
We don't look like girls.
You don't look like
And who's our latest one? Sam.
Star still of us in Vegas.
Clear all over.
Okay.
Yeah. The other one's a bin picker. Picked up bin. Cupid.
That's very clever, isn't that? Where are they made?
Italy.
Are they? Italy.
We do bring them in, sir.
Yeah, very good. And you're selling a few?
They're all sold.
It's been a bit tough for green, hasn't it?
Well, the green growers will go over and never leave it. There's just so many.
And
hopefully the price will come up.
Too much.
Too much. Some of us can't convert over. A few of us that converted over many years ago to Samoa.
Yeah.
And then they said, sorry, we don't want it. Although if we got caught out, so we'd be, new farm, bloke hell. We've already had our fingers burnt, we'll wait till see it goes. First, and then we'll convert later.
As they tap their way off the green. Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, the Honourable Prime Minister, and very important people, and anyone who has not yet had the hand shaken by John Key, welcome.
Here today. We're here to open the 42nd Fieldays, and this is an event that every year just gets bigger and bigger. 130,000 people will be here through the field days over the next 4 days, getting an opportunity to see just how successful New Zealand agriculture is and what a huge contribution it's making to the New Zealand economy. The theme of this year's field days is innovation. And when I was watching the mighty All Whites last night, as they drew 1-1 with Slovakia, I couldn't help but notice out of the corner of my eye some of the innovation that the New Zealand supporters in the crowd had. They turned those musical instruments, those vuvuzelas, into a drinking instrument. So innovation follows Kiwis all around the world. But we need the agricultural sector in New Zealand to be strong. It's the largest part of our economy. It is going to be a huge part of the growth story that is New Zealand. And over the next 20 years, we expect the demand for food to increase by 50%. And it really won't matter whether you're involved in agriculture or horticulture or viticulture. The demand is going to be tremendous, particularly driven out of Asia. And from the government's point of view, we're very focused on that. Science was at the heart of our budget for 2010, along with the tax reforms that were there. And that was really trying to say that if we can just spend more money in science and innovation, if we can tie in our universities and our CRIs and our polytechs into the commercial sectors in New Zealand, then we can get on-farm production to rise, we can move up the value chain, New Zealanders can earn more and do better. Finally, can I just focus on one point? There's a few of the protesters in front of me around the ETS. I want to acknowledge them, and I say to you that I understand the issues that farmers have and the concerns they have, but it's my view that New Zealand does have to play its part when it comes to climate change, and I'd say that strongly because I believe if we don't, the markets for our goods and services will be reduced. I think eventually the cost on the New Zealand economy will be greater, and if you believe in climate change and you believe it will ultimately lead to changes in weather patterns, then the single most affected group in New Zealand will be farmers. And it may not be the generation of farmers that's standing in front of me today, but it will be their sons and their daughters that take over those farms. And I think as a guardian of New Zealand, as a custodian of policy in New Zealand, as Prime Minister of New Zealand, I'd actually be derelict in my duties if I didn't ensure that future generations of New Zealanders could farm the land. I don't think New Zealand should be doing more than the rest of the world. There will be a review in 2011, and I've made it quite clear that in the end, if the rest of the world doesn't step up and do a bit more, then New Zealand certainly won't. But we do have to play our part, and I do think farmers should think that through. And I think some of the numbers that you've heard about from the ETS are simply utterly wrong. The impact on the farm will be somewhat. 3 cents a kilo of milk solids, but if you compare that to the average funding on a farm, it's $1.25. And in the end, I think you've got to ask yourself, is that an insurance policy that's worth having? So Nick Smith's around today. He's going to be talking about around the ETS and about climate change policy. I think it's worth having a bit of a chat to him, because you'll see when you hear from him all the things that are taking place and going on. Finally, to everybody that's involved in organising the field days, this is a huge event. It doesn't happen without the corporate sponsorship. It doesn't happen without the enormous efforts of so many people to make this possible. New Zealand is a remarkable country, but we're particularly remarkable because we lead the world in agricultural innovation. We're feeding an increasingly large part of the world. It's a world that's becoming wealthier and that desire more of our products. And as a result of the field days, New Zealand agriculture is going to be in better heart. The economy is going to earn more, and we're going to do better. And I think you can see from the anticipated payout or expected payout that Fonterra indicated about a month or so ago, just how strong global demand is. So well done for being part of the field days. Thanks very much to the barbershop quartet, or the, I guess you're a bit more than a quartet, the band that's going to sing for us later on. Can I say how beautifully dressed you are in blue? You boys look, girls look tremendous. And it's great to see the national government's fine weather policies working so well here at the field days today. Have a great afternoon. I officially declare your 42nd field days open.
We're now inviting the MAF Biosecurity Beagle Dog team to...
Oh, you are right.
Hi there, we're at the 42nd Fieldays here at Mystery Creek, and this is the scene of the largest agricultural show in New Zealand and one of the largest agricultural shows in the world. 130,000 people coming through the Fieldays over the next 4 days. I had the privilege of opening it, and the theme this year is innovation, so looking at all sorts of changes on the farm and agricultural systems in the way of farming in New Zealand. You see people from all over the world here coming to see what New Zealand's up to, countries and companies being represented here, showcasing their wares and encouraging New Zealanders and those from who tour from overseas to buy their products and get a sense of the latest and greatest innovation. From New Zealand's point of view, we're at the cutting edge of a lot of technology, so again, it's very, very good for farmers. And there's been a great mood and atmosphere here. Farmers obviously pleased about the anticipated dairy payout of hopefully the better part of $8 for the 2011 season. So there's a lot of optimism, people feeling a lot better about what's going on. A range of different issues as I walk around the place, some asking questions about ETS, but a little less than I actually anticipated there would be. But yeah, again, people asking about all sorts of different aspects of agricultural life, whether it's irrigation and right through to reform of the Resource Management Act. Agriculture is hugely important to New Zealand, our largest part of our economy, and a huge part of the growth story for New Zealand as we anticipate the world's demand for food will increase by 50% over the next 20 years. So the future is bright for New Zealand. If we continue to innovate, continue to use science, research and technology, then we'll be at the cutting edge of agricultural production around the world. And as Prime Minister of New Zealand, that makes me pretty happy.